Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro YouTube channel. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, and today we are with another Shopify tutorial. And in today's tutorial, we are learning how to add buttons in our Shopify product page. And this button will take you to the next product and the previous product. So recently, our client wanted to have that kind of feature, and we added this feature for our client. So I thought to create a video for you guys in order to understand how you can add two buttons which will navigate to next and previous product. These features are not available by default in Shopify. We will be doing this in Dawn theme. So once you click on next button, it will take you to the next product, and once you click on the previous product, it will take you to the previous product, and it is set to be work on all collections, so it's not collection specific. So without further ado, let's jump into the tutorial. So guys, that's how the default product page looks like in Dawn theme. And we will be adding next and previous button just above the title here on product page. And in order to do that, let's go back to our backend by navigating to /admin. Guys, before we proceed, one small request: don't forget to hit the subscribe button, like the video, and comment if you have any question about it. If you are having problem implementing the code which I shared with you guys, feel free to let me know in the comments below. Okay, so after navigating to dashboard of our Shopify, you will see a screen like this where you need to click on online store. And from online store, click on actions, then edit code. Before editing the code, I keep repeating this again and again. Make sure to duplicate your theme and have a backup of it, so if you mess up something in code, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now click on edit code. And from there, go to your main-prduct.liquid file. Here's the file where we will be adding the code which we need to add. Click on that. And from here, we will add this code on line number 33. So you can change the position of buttons depend on where you want it. I am adding the buttons above the title of the product. You can also add it below these tabs. You can also add it below above the similar products if you want to. What I'm gonna do, I'll add it here. So I have already copied the code which I want to add. So here's the code. Just add some comments in order to make sure next previous button code. So these comments will remind you that where you actually added the code, and if you want to remove it, you can simply remove it later on. Okay, so we added the code here. Now hit save. Don't worry about the code. I'll put the link of a blog post in YouTube description, so you can easily copy and paste the code. Okay, now I'll go back to the product page and hit refresh. So here we have our previous and next button. What I'm gonna do, I'll add some CSS to make it look good, and I'm also changing it to say the next and previous. So just type it previous here, and on this one mention next. Okay, hit save. Now for CSS, search for the CSS file here, and we'll be adding our code in base.css file. Scroll down to the bottom. I'm going to add another comment line next previous button code. So in case if I mess something else in my theme, I can simply remove the CSS which is within this comment range. Okay, so I'm going to copy the CSS code. And here's the CSS code. Again, don't worry about the code. I'll put the link of the blog post in the YouTube description so you can easily copy and paste. Okay, so we have our CSS ready. Now hit save. Okay, go back to the product page and hit refresh. And here we go. Our next and previous button are looking nice. And click on next. Here we go. We have been pointed to our product, which is next in the queue. And if I click on previous, it should take me to the same product which I was on before. Click on previous again, it will take to the previous product from that. Okay, so now we don't have any previous product. It's not showing the previous button, as now we only have the next product. Now if I go to the last product, it should hide the next button as well. Go next again, next. Okay, so that's the last product in my store. And as you can see, the next button is not anymore showing up because we don't have any more products showing up next. Cool. So our functionality is working. Now let's take a look at the mobile version of how it looks in our mobile. Okay, so when I click on previous button, yeah, that looks fine. I mean, we have image showing up and we have on top our next and previous buttons. Okay guys, so that's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys liked it. If you do, please don't forget to comment, like and share. Have a great day.